that's in every fighter. It's that desire to rise through the ranks and go from underdog to world champion.
On January 17th, the toughest tournament in sports.
What an incredible fight!
Comes home to Spike.
Oh my God! I do not believe it!
That is MMA at its best.
Bellator MMA. The tournament begins Thursday, January 17th, live on Spike.
Hey guys, JJ Ambrose. I'm fighting January 17th in Irvine, California, Bellator, against Brian Warren. This training camp's been like one of the best ones I've ever had. Once, like, I'm 2 weeks out and I'm not achy all over. Usually everything is just sore and I'm just trying to recover, but. Just trained really smart. Picked up a really good strength and conditioning coach, Mark Mariani. He's been working with him. Got Olavo for Jiu-Jitsu MMA, and he's just been a really good mentor throughout this whole thing. And I've been crushing pads with Samkor. I mean, that guy doesn't need any introduction. He's just a stud, and he's been kind of training me the way he trained. So I feel really good for this
fight.
This is definitely going to be my coming out party. I feel like I haven't really shown my true self in, you know, on the main stage. This is pretty much my big shot in Bellator. And, I mean, I trained like it was a world title shot, you know. It's just going to be a really good fight, and I think really am looking to showcase everything that I have. You know, I really want to like define myself by this fight. Like, you know, just hard, fast, furious, and just, you know, get the big W, get the finish. It's going to be a good one. Throughout this training camp, I've been training a lot of stand-up and a lot of wrestling. I feel like I have like all the necessary tools to beat Brian. I know my grappling is better than his. He's a good kickboxer, but I don't know how much Muay Thai he's been doing. I already was doing Muay Thai with a former guest over at Tiger Muay Thai, and I can't imagine that I would have a coach in my camp that just learn Muay Thai after a few months, especially from, you know, Ferran. Just, it seems kind of silly. The guy's got one fight and he picks this dude as his head coach. It was just kind of a terrible decision. But either way, I'm comfortable on the feet, and if it goes to the ground, I'll be able to finish him in the first round. After this W over Brian, I mean, it'd be awesome to get another shot in the tournament. I mean, that's where all the money's at. That's where, you know, all the exposure's at, you know, and that's pretty much all I care about, is just getting the big fights, getting the exposure. I mean, the money's cool too, but I mean, it's not what I'm after, it's not what I'm fighting for. A few years ago, I decided that I needed a change in pace. You know, everything's just really hectic and fast in the States, you know. It would take me an hour to get to the training sometimes because of traffic. And, you know, the stand-ups, it's good in the States, but it's not like Thailand. You know, the Muay Thai fighters have the best stand-up in the world. So, you know, I came over here, I wanted to change the pace, learn some Muay Thai, and the difference between training over here and there, I guess in the States there's a lot more ego as far as like sparring goes and stuff. You know, everyone's trying to just knock each other's heads off. And if you train Thai style, they don't really spar hard because they have to fight, you know, once every other week. You know, you can't spar hard and maintain like good fights like that. It just doesn't work out. You have to rest, you have to recuperate, and you just got to trust your training partners. So over here, you know, it's a lot less ego. So it's cool. I like it. Mentally, I've changed a lot in the last couple of years. You know, I used to have this like do or die attitude. Like if I don't win this fight, you know, it's over. You know, there's no more pressure anymore. I found out that the only reason why I fight is because I love competition. I love going out there and testing myself. I'm not trying to prove myself to anyone. I don't care what anyone thinks of me. I care about what I think of me, you know. Like, I go home and I look at myself in the mirror, and if I'm proud of myself, then, you know, it's a job well done, you know. So anytime I'm going in for a fight now, there's no pressure. It's just I got to go out there and I got to give my all. I got to beat that guy's ass because he's in the way of me feeling good about myself, you know. Put the check on the back burner. I want to feel good about me, you know. I got a lot of ego to take care of. To me, like, I'm not putting any other fighters down, but I feel like there's so much, like, bullshit out there nowadays. Guys are just getting these stupid haircuts and lots of tattoos. And they're trying to look the part, and that's all they care about. They're worried about getting sponsors and interviews and crap, you know. They want the girls chasing them. I don't care about that. I don't care what anyone's thinking about me. I'm just going to go out there and, you know, like, work as hard as I can. You know, I prove myself every day in the gym. I show up on time and, you know, I give 110%. And I go home, eat and sleep, you know. That's all I do. So I'm not saying follow me, but at least you know what you're getting when you do follow me. Yeah, I want to thank all the guys at Phuket Top Team. They really carried me through this. Had a lot of things happen in the last few months, and, you know, Phuket Top Team's just been there the whole time. Olavo, you know, Andrew, even my coaches, Samkor. Just want to thank 40 Thieves for always sponsoring me no matter what. Pony Grappling, you know, so many sponsors to name. I appreciate all you guys. I'll make sure I mention you in my news feed on Facebook and Twitter. Yeah, Super JJ Ambrose at Twitter, JJ Ambrose at Facebook, and superjjambrose.com.
Yeah! Shut up! Shut up!